Hi, I'm Jason with Kimray, and today I'm going to show you how to repair the energy exchange glycol pump. Before you get started, you'll want to make sure that you're wearing all of your proper PPE. For example, I'll be wearing gloves and safety glasses. You'll want to start by removing any plugs from your suction or discharge blocks, and then slowly opening your needle valves to relieve any trapped pressure. Be sure that you're standing to the side of the pump just in case there's any discharge. Remove your check valve caps and the O-rings. Use needle nose pliers to remove the check valves and a pick to remove the O-rings. Use the seat puller and a wrench to remove the suction block seats, and then remove the O-rings. Remove the discharge block from the main piston body and use the seat insert tool and mallet to remove the discharge seats. Remove the O-rings from the discharge seats. Remove the suction block from the main piston body and remove the O-rings from the back side of the suction block. Flip the pump upside down and loosen the fitting from the pilot piston discharge tubing. Remove the tubing from the main piston valve housing. Remove the pilot piston discharge tubing and remove the legs closest to the main piston valve housing. Loosen the bolts and remove the main piston valve housing. And remove the O-rings. Use needle nose pliers to remove the D-slide. Put the main piston valve housing in a vise and remove the D-slide guides. Use two wrenches to loosen both ends of the needle valve assembly tubing. Hold the fitting elbow with one wrench and use the other to loosen the fitting cap. This will prevent the fitting from breaking. Replace the legs and flip the pump right side up. Loosen the bolts on the pilot piston valve housing. Remove the control tubing. Remove Remove the O-ring from the pilot piston valve housing. Before loosening the bolts, turn the tubing elbow to protect the threads. Loosen the bolts on the cylinder head. Hold the gland against the pump body and slide out the cylinder head and remove the O-ring. Remove the cylinder. Use a wrench to hold the piston rod in place and loosen the nut from the other side of the piston. Slide out the piston and then remove the O-ring and two backups. Remove the O-ring from the piston retainer groove. Remove the O-ring from the piston rod gland. Remove the two O-rings located in the communicating hole grooves from the pilot piston gland. Work the piston rod from side to side to jar loose the piston rod seal retainers. Remove the O-ring and backup from the piston rod seal retainer. And slide out the piston rod. Loosen the bolts and remove the pilot piston caps, then remove the backup from the pilot piston cap. Tap the pilot piston cap with a mallet and slide it out of the pump. If the piston bearings don't come out on their own, put the Kimray seal retainer tool into the pilot piston hole and tap with a mallet to remove them. Place pilot piston valve housing in a vise. Remove the needle valve handles and the stem lock with an Allen wrench. If the handle is rusted, the head on the Allen screw may break off. If this occurs, use the handle of a wrench to break it off. It will then need to be replaced. Loosen the needle valve caps and then remove the needle valve bonnet. Remove needle valve cap and unthread the stem. Remove the D-slide guides. Remove the backup and O-ring from the bonnet. Run your parts through a parts washer. If you don't have access to a washer, get each part as clean as possible. That concludes the disassembly of the pump. In the next video, I'll show you how to inspect individual parts for wear and tear.